So, welcome back to our students from the last round. One success already, and I'm going to ask the new team to introduce themselves.
I'm George, I do history.
I'm Max, study chemistry.
I'm Tom, I study politics.
I'm Hardy, studying chemistry.
Please welcome Derwent and our students, as they're called. Fantastic, let us kick off. And Gab has helpfully put her curse that I need to start reading from. Thank you. Which American writer who died in 1982 was a prolific of short stories to the New Yorker magazine, as well as the author of full-length novels, including Falconer in 1977 and the Wap Shots Chronicle in 1957?
John Updike.
Can you say that again?
John Updike.
No. No, it was John Cheever, whoever that is. On a compass, how many degrees are there between north, northwest, and east, southeast? North, northwest.
180.
No.
135.
Correct. You guys can't see my screen, can you?
Now it goes.
I keep edging back thinking I'm just going, ooh. Okay, 180, that's five. Wait, what did you say?
135.
Oh, you got it right, sorry. Right, okay, on to the bonus questions then. So, what name is given to the physical law which states that the heat current due to radiation emitted from a surface is proportional to the temperature of a surface raised to the fourth power? It's not a short word. Which is unsurprising.
Is it the...
What name is given to the physical law?
The third law of thermodynamics?
It's Stefan Boltzmann law. Right, let's see if you get these. In terms of Boltzmann's constant K and temperature T, what is the average transactional kinetic energy of a molecule of an ideal gas?
And only Birch.
8.314, ideal gas constant.
That's weirdly specific. No, it's 3/2 kT or 3/2 kT. Yeah. Moving on. According to Boltzmann, what thermodynamic quantity is given by Boltzmann's constant times the natural logarithm of the number of microstates corresponding to a given macrostate?
Entropy?
Yes, correct. I didn't even see it properly. That's great. In the UK government, by what title is the Second Lord of the Treasury commonly known?
Lord President of the Council.
Oh, come on, Ron.
The Chancellor of the Exchequer.
It is, correct.
I should know that.
Okay. I was like, do it.
Yeah.
No. Three bonus questions this time on Dublin. Sackville Street was in 1924 renamed after which nationalist leader of the early 19th century?
Nationalist leaders of Ireland in the early 19th century.
Martin, 1924.
Go for it.
Martin McGuinness. I don't know which one. Michael Collins.
No, it's Daniel O'Connell. No. Now Museum, which jail near Phoenix Park is particularly associated with the struggle for Irish independence? Its inmates have included Charles Stuart Parnell, Michael Davitt, and Eamon de Valera.
No idea.
Go on.
It's an Irish word, it's not easy.
What's the film called?
What's the film called?
Oh, okay. No, I don't
know. We're not. You don't know. It's Kilmainham. I butchered that in Irish, but it's Kilmainham or something like that. Which 19th century building became a symbol of the 1916 Isa Rising, having been seized by insurgents, the proclamation of the Irish Republic was read out from its steps?
Is this like Stormont or something?
That's in Northern Ireland. That's not in Dublin.
Oh, I've got no idea.
There's questions on Dublin.
Yeah. It could be the Parliament Building, but I can't remember what it's called. Leinster House?
It's the General Post Office. Oh. In astronomy, what term denotes the distance between the foci of an eclipse divided by the major axis? In everyday use, the same word indicates an unconscious propensity towards the whimsical or unconventional behaviour?
Eccentricity.
That's correct. Three bonus questions now on royal emblems. From his title as Earl of March, a white lion was a badge of which English king born in 1442?
All right.
That is niche knowledge. James the First, possibly. As is everything in his composition.
James one was. Yeah, go.
James the First.
It's Edward the Roman numerals fourth. Have to subtract. Which of Edward the Fourth's sons, who also became king, used the emblem of the white boar?
I got the last one wrong, but I think that one might be Richard the Third.
Take it.
Yeah. Richard III.
That is correct. Well done. And finally, on royal emblems, a white hart was the personal emblem of which English king, who's depicted wearing it on the Wilton diptych, which sounds strange, like a rude word, but there we go. Diptych.
White hart, king white hart.
Henry VIII, maybe.
Yeah, take it.
Henry VIII.
So close. It's Richard II. That was a joke. The UK's red telephone boxes were designed in the 1920s by which architect, who were also responsible for the Waterloo Bridge and the grandson of the designer of the Albert Mall and the Foreign Office? Which architect? Red phone boxes, Waterloo Bridge.
Edwin Lutyens?
No.
Not a clue.
Albert Memorial, Foreign Office? Giles Gilbert Scott. Three bonus questions. Oh, no. Oh, gosh. Right, moving on then. Which 18th century Prussian mathematician is best known for the conjecture he made in a letter to Euler, E-U-L-E-R, that every even integer greater than 2 is the sum of 2 primes?
Mersenne?
No.
Oh,
you said that's confidence. No, that's no, right. I know it.
Matt?
No, Goldbach. It's Christian Goldbach. Goldbach.
It wasn't fair.
Okay, next question then. In what decade did all of the following occur? Oh, it's a long time ago. The construction of the Bastille in Paris was completed. England and France signed the Truce of Lulinhem. L-E-U-L-I-N-G-hem. How do you say that? Do we know? I would never know. That's brilliant. None of us know. Ending the second phase of the Hundred Years' War and finally the Peasants' Revolt. Which decade was this?
1380s.
Correct. Well done.
I can't believe I said that.
Considering no one even knew what the truths were, that's impressive. Three bonus questions then on the solar system. What property of the sun is the appropriate SI unit, in the appropriate SI unit, sorry, has a value of 2 times 10 to the 30? Is that right?
What's the question?
I can say that again. So what property of the sun in the appropriate SI unit has the value of 2, is that 2 times 10 or 2 to the power of 10? 2 times 10 to the 2 to the 30.
Temperature?
No, it's mass. I'm equally confused. What body in the solar system has a mass of approximately 1 millisun or 2 times 10 to the 27 kilograms?
Jupiter.
Correct. Oh my goodness. Yeah, getting clapped for that. That's brilliant. And finally then, what body of the solar system has a mass of approximately 3 microsuns?
Earth?
Correct. Okay, next question. The strait known as the Kattegat separates which two countries of Northern Europe?
Denmark and Sweden?
Correct. Well done. So, three bonus questions on banks. Who announced his resignation as president of the World Bank in May 2007 following controversy after the lavish pay rise he negotiated for his partner?
Is that Robert Zoellick?
No, it's Paul Wolfowitz.
Oh, yeah.
Winner of the Nobel Peace Prize in 2006, The Grameen Bank was founded by Muhammad Yunus in 1976 to offer small collateral free loans to the rural poor in which country?
India?
No, it's Bangladesh. And finally, who served as the governor of the Bank of England from 2003 until 2013?
Mervyn King.
That's correct. Well done to Rich for starting the claps every time. Fantastic.
Thank you, Rich.
Next question then, open to all. What links the given names of the 14th and 32nd US presidents? An explorer who died seeking the Northwest Passage in 18...
John.
No. In 1847, and a singer known as the Queen of Soul. Oh, I'd get this.
Franklin.
Correct.
I should have waited. Never mind.
What name is given to the adaptation in an animal whereby it resembles another organism, part of an organism, or the intimate, inanimate background?
Mimicry.
Correct. Named after 19th century English naturalist, which form of mimicry, involves resemblance of an unprotected animal to a related protected species?
Darwinian?
It's Batesian mimicry. Named after 19th century German zoologist, what type of mimicry is displayed when a number of different species converge to have the same appearance as a noxious species, so adopting a shared protection? I'll give you a clue. It's got mimicry in it.
Yes. No clue.
It's Malarian mimicry.
Cool.
Woohoo! Moving on to everyone. The war between Russia... God, I can't speak. The war between Austria and Prussia in 1866.
The Brothers' War.
No! In 1866, which culminated... I sound like Jeremy Paxman. Which culminated... First time this evening. Which culminated in the Prussian victory at the Battle of Sadowa is usually known by the name... By what name due to its approximate duration?
7 weeks war.
The 30 Years' War.
No, I'm afraid it's the 7 weeks' War. Next one. What imperial measure is equivalent to 453.6 grams? Imperial measure.
A pound.
Correct. Now on to, let's go. Yes, Rich has started. We'll follow Rich. More clap. Three bonus questions now on UK counties. Oh, I love this. This is so niche. I love it. Since April 1998, which English county has had no county council? God, the poor things. All its local government powers have been devolved to six unitary authorities. Okay. No county council with having been devolved to six unitary authorities.
Middlesex?
That doesn't exist anymore. It's Berkshire or Berkshire even. Berkshire. Next question. Which preserved country and former local government county of Wales contains towns such as Tredegar? How do you say it?
Just carry on.
Sorry, sorry. And Beaufort and villages such as Trafil and Nantia Witch.
Martinshire?
It's Gwent. That was a dodgy last word there. Which county in England has borders on Greater Manchester, Nottinghamshire, Staffordshire, West Yorkshire, Leicestershire, South Yorkshire, and Cheshire? I can say that again if you'd like.
Derbyshire?
Correct.
Let's get one more.
Yeah.
In terms of the letters that they contain, what feature do the following words have in common? Chintz, abhors, almost, effort, and billow.
Consecutive letters.
Alphabetical order.
Yes, correct. Letters in alphabetical order. Three bonus questions on the Italian Renaissance art. In each case, name the school of art that the following artists belong to. Domenichino and the Caracci family of, this is terrible, Annibale, Agostino and Ludovico. I can hear people laughing. Do you want to guess?
Why not? Not a clue.
It's Bologna.
Oh, okay.
I think. Douche. Me to do. But I'll skip that. Martini, Martino di Balmetolmo and Duccio.
I'm just going to guess a advertised city. Pisa?
No, it's Siena.
Okay.
And the last one I can pronounce is Donatello, Bocelli and Masolino.
Florence?
Correct! Yes! Correct! Next question, if you all. Awarded for their services to the analysis of crystal structure by means of X-rays, what was the surname of the father and son who shared the Nobel Peace Prize for Physics in 1915?
The Nobel Peace Prize for Physics.
The Nobel Prize for Physics, apologies. In 1915, yeah.
Rad.
Correct.
Oh, very good.
I made this up for the other two.
Three bonus questions then on the post-Reformation English prelates.
Yeah, that's me now.
What is a prelate?
In each case, give the name of the monarch during whose reign the following were Archbishop of Canterbury: Matthew Parker, Edmund Grindal, and John Whitgift.
Post-Reformation is like Charles II.
Give the name of the monarch when these...
Yeah. Who else would it be though? Charles II and like William the...
You go for whatever.
Charles II.
No, it's Elizabeth the First.
Yeah.
What about William Lord and George Abbott?
Charles II.
No, it's Charles I. And finally, Archibald Campbell Tate, Edward White, Benson and Frederick Temple.
Should we go for Charles II?
Yes.
Okay, Charles II.
No, it's Victoria, I'm afraid. Right, now the moment you've all been waiting for, it's the picture round. On the screen behind you, or me rather, you will see a picture of a flag. Name the country this flag belongs to. Oh, it's got some good bonuses to this. Good bonuses.
Ethiopia? Yes.
It is Ethiopia. Well done.
Nice. Well done.
You've now unlocked the bonus round for three bonus questions on African flag.
Let's do this, yeah. It'll be fun.
Ghana.
Correct.
Guinea-Bissau.
Guinea-Bissau is correct. And last one?
Mali.
Mali. Well done. In psychology, the pathetic or superior oblique muscle, I think I'm saying it right, is one of the six that enable the movement of which sensory organ?
The eye.
Correct. You've unlocked three bonus questions on psychology. Which American was considered the father of humanistic psychology, which gave his name to a hierarchy of needs, which contains that as human meets basic needs?
Maslow.
Yes, correct. Which psychologist of child development asserted in his cognitive development theory that children are born with a basic mental structure and from this construct a mental word around them?
I think that might be Piaget?
No, it's Jean Piaget. Wait,
that's what he said.
Correct! Oh, it's been a busy day. And the last one then. Designed to yield information about unconscious mental processes, a test first published in 1991 in Psychodiagnostik by Hermann Rostrach used monochrome images formed by what?
Ink.
Correct. Ink blots is correct.
Bahnadine.
And the next one then. How are we doing for time? We're okay. Is this the last one?
About all right, 20 all right.
Minutes. What popular verse form usually consists of five predominantly anapestic lines rhyming A-A-B-B-A.
Limerick.
Correct. Thank you for saving me on that one. Three bonus questions on bells then. As you do. Which American-born poet wrote The Bell Jar, published in 1963?
Sylvia Plath.
Correct. Which novelist is the author of The Bell, published in 1958 and set in a lay community in a country house?
American author, was it, or just an author?
Which novelist is the author?
1958.
Graham Greene, maybe?
Go for it.
Graham Greene.
No, it's Iris Murdoch. Or Iris, yeah. Last question in this section then. The 1954 film comedy based on The Bells of St. Trinians is based on the creations of which British illustrator?
Oh, great film. Is it that one that died recently?
I don't know. Is that enough?
Or just like Quentin Blake, that's the only British illustrator I can think of, but it's not that. Yeah. Quentin Blake, but it's not
no,
that.
No, it's Ronald Searle. Last question then. Oh, my favourite thing to do. In snooker and billiards, which French word is used for a shot played with the cue nearly vertical so as to achieve a sharp swerve in the cue ball?
Vertical.
No, it's a masse.
They don't get a chance.
So there we go. That is the end of the round.
I can't believe I dropped.
I didn't give him a chance, did I?
No.
Do you want a chance?
But we've already given the answer.
You said the answer. So.
Oh yeah.
I mean, if you want to give us another question and take a mulligan on that one, we'll do that.
I'm afraid we're out of time. But yeah, the scores are above with 70 points. It's our students, but in front with 110, it's our Derwent students. Congratulations.